Hello and welcome to the video user guide for MyInventory.shop. This video will take you through the standard ordering process. We're going to start off here on the MyInventory.shop website. Now this page has been designed to be very simple with just the two main buttons here as well as a little help section down below. We're going to start off by pressing the shopper's login. And this will take us to the page where we can enter our username and password. Your shop may look different from the one I'm using because your administrator has several configuration options. You may have large category pictures as you see here, or you may have a list as you see here. In either case, clicking on the picture or the title will take you into that category. Before we dig into choosing the items, let me take a moment to explain the rest of the interface. On the left-hand side of the screen, you'll see we have a variety of icons. From the top, we have a logo. It's just a logo set up by the administrator. Under that, we have the expansion bar button, which will widen to add the text descriptions for the icons. Next are the three shop buttons. The first one will take you back to the main page here. The second will take you into your cart so you can review items, save, or submit the order. The final icon in the shop group will take you into the page so you can review your previous orders. The next two icons will allow you to see pending orders, which are either pending approval, if your system is running an approval, or pending release. Although a note, not all systems will use approval. That is an option set up by the admin. And at the bottom of the panel, you'll see we also have the I icon for our wiki and the logout button. And here at the top of the page, we have three options to allow you to go in and either filter the categories, as well as flag your more important or commonly selected categories. And the options here will allow you to go in and sort. Of course, we also have your search here as well. Okay, let's go ahead and place an order. I'm going to start off by getting into some chips. Within the category, you can see the different items, and their descriptions, and image, and possibly more depending on how your administrator has configured the shop. Now, here we can go and we can type in the number that we need. We can also go in and use the arrows to increase the numbers as well. Just add a few items here to my cart, and I'm going to go ahead and head back to the category so that I can pick some different items here. Okay, and now that I've selected all of my items, let's go ahead and move into the cart to place my order. And for that, we'll just use the cart icon. Here in the shopping cart screen, you'll be able to select your specific customer or department this order or request needs to apply to. You can also select a specific address if there are multiple affiliated. Sales order number, as well as the order date, will be automatically filled in for you. And here under the General tab, you can see each of the items that you selected, as well as the quantity, and potentially your costs as well. Now, additional fields like the images, the units of measure, priced cost, and tax may be available just depending on how your admin has configured the shop. Once we've verified all the items in the order, we're ready to either save, or in our case, submit. In the pending section, the approvals icon is only applicable for shops which use an approval process, those that have been approved, or for shops without approval processes, the orders will go directly into the release icon. This will have your release status in here as well, where approved has been received, and once released, the order has been completed and the items issued out. Reorders are available by using the previous orders clipboard. From here, we can go directly into the order details and place the reorder. Thank you very much for joining me, and happy shopping.